Here they come. Never had this many before. Never had 14 runners before. All right, everybody run by. Hey, I ran with you guys the other day. Crazy Americans. Okay, Steve Ray here. I'm the leader of this group. So now you know how I make these videos and movies all the time. I just hold this. And we're at the Jaffa Gate. When you ran out of this gate, you were heading to Joppa. That's why they call it Jaffa Gate. Just like Damascus Gate, when you left that, you were heading to Damascus. So everybody doing all right? Yeah, this goes right into the Christian quarter. Go in here, down to the left, you'd be at the Holy Sepulchre in 6 or 7 minutes. All right, here we go. We're heading up towards Mount Zion. Now we're going to the upper room. People are always surprised how close it is, because on the bus it seems like it's a long way away.
I know, you said the upper room, I was like,
yep, right in there and around. Oh, it's locked. It says enter though. Okay, go right out and turn left. Go right out and turn left. Hi, Tom. Hi, Mike. Father Jacob. Sean, Emily, everybody's coming along here. And I'll bring up the rear this time. Jesus came up and down these steps. This is all from the time of Christ. A lot of this is what they're digging. Right up there, there are three gates that are walled in, and that's the gates that Jesus would have gone in when he was here, up onto the Temple Mount, and then he would have taught. That's the Al-Aqsa Mosque up there. That's for the men, and the gold dome is for the women. So even in churches in Jordan and some places in the Middle East today, the men and women do not sit together at Mass, men on one side, women on the other. So back, even the Muslims do that.
Steve, is there a reason that both the Golden Gates and these, the ones that Jesus used, are walled up? Is that just a coincidence?
This one, I don't know why. The other one is walled up because the Muslims want to keep the Messiah out, too. It was specific that the Messiah is coming back. We'll wall that, keep him out. We'll put a cemetery in front of it because no Jewish priest would ever go through a cemetery. So now we've got double lock. He can't get in. I don't think it's going to work. When he comes, he's going to come. Nobody's going to stop him. How you doing, Father Jacob?
I'm doing fine.
You're doing great.
Good job, Susie.
And more archaeology here around the southern
wall. There's Sean showing off, beating Emily and running backwards.
So, this is the Golden Gate, which is walled up to keep the Messiah out. It's the eighth gate, and it's walled up. And then right across the street there is the Garden of Gethsemane. Remember, that's where we had Mass right there at the church. And then the trees to the left are the Garden of Gethsemane. Yep. So there you got the Mount of Olives.
Let's open on.
Saturday. Yeah, you could go in there on Saturday, yeah?
Golden Gate, because it's... See a small, round, silver thing that looks like a star. Are those like survey marks?
They must be. I haven't noticed them. You're more observant than I am. Show me one if you see it.
I will.
There we go, up the stairs past St. Stephen's Gate. We're on our way now to Herod Gate. Everybody's still hanging in there, too.
Oh, yeah.
Amazing. Thank you. run, Father. You did great.
It was a great run, very long, but I'm tired. But it's okay, I did it.
You did it.
Yeah.
You stayed right with us. Good for
exactly.
you.
Exactly.
Emily and Sean.
It was long, but it was good. I'm glad I did it, except I'm really tired and thirsty now.
Glad we got you up, right?
Yep.
All right.
Since they said it was really long, it was really short and fun. And beautiful to see the city at this time of day.
And you've done this already every morning since you've been here. Mike.
This shirt, it lies.
Born to run.
Not born to run. But that was a great trip.
Tom.
Oh, this was great. I was able to create a memory with my family that we'll never forget.
Yeah, we got a nice picture of all of you.
The greatest dog I've ever had. And here in heaven.
We got to see a lot of Jerusalem, too.
Gotta say, it was a killer. But it was outstanding, just outstanding to run around her. Jesus.
Ties everything together, doesn't
yes,
it?
She does.
All right, you married couples,
what do
you
think?
No place better to die in the Holy Land.
All right, you guys won the race. You're the first ones. And you went in every gate, didn't you, Andrew?
I did. I made it into every gate.
In and out of every gate.
I didn't think this old guy had the kick left in him.
It was fun. Hallelujah, we're done.
Hallelujah, we're done. All right.
It was a good run. It was definitely a once-in-a-lifetime experience. I won't be doing that again. And I'm ready to go get some water.
Good. All right. Well, thanks for going with me, everybody. Steve Ray here, reporting for EWTN. At the Notre Dame in Jerusalem. Had a great run with all these folks. It was the largest group I've ever had. I think there are 14 of us that ran. And that was the best yet. So now we're all going to go in and get some water, shower, and a breakfast.